Hello guys, welcome to a new session. Today we are going to discuss about broken image. Broken image or broken link, this is a very common question in any interview. Like the interviewer will ask you how to know whether particular link is broken or particular image is broken, or how many images are broken or how many links are broken in a particular page. So if you go a lot of websites, the solution is given like just get the source from the image tag or anchor tag, okay, and then you hit with the HTTP client or with the REST assured API, okay, and when you get a 200 response, it means the link is not broken or image is not broken, okay. This is a very common solution it is given, and it's working a lot of places, it's working, but at some places or in some website or there is a chance that this solution is not going to work. Okay, the broken image has a lot of things. It's not only broken because the link is not available. There are multiple scenarios are there where an image can be broken. It can be like you are referring an image with a PNG, you have uploaded with a JPG. Okay, but you are referring with a PNG. Server is not available, redirection is happening, all attributes has not been given, okay, sometimes your length and width are so small that does not look good, this is not loading properly in that length and width. There are multiple scenarios are there where you can say the image is not loading properly, okay. So in this website you can see it, which is running my local, here is a tag image and has sourced this. This is an image, it has sourced this. These two are broken, and this is not broken because we are using the proper path, like image folder. Here the proper path is not there. So in my website, four images are there. If I see how many images with the help of a tag, I can see four. Out of four, two are broken and two are not broken. Now what is the challenge here? How to know whether image is broken or not, or a link is broken or not? It's very easy to find out. First, what I'm doing it, I'm running a local machine, my broken image, I'm just navigating to that path, maximizing it, and then I'm putting an implicit weight with a 30 second time minute second, then with the find elements with the help of a tag name image, as you can see, okay, image. So this is a tag called image. Similar to the, if it is a broken link, you can use anchor tag like this one. If I give this one, this anchor tag. From here, you need to get it href, not the source. Okay, so if you want to see href is working or not, or anchor tag is working, this is a link for link. And this is for the images. So I have used image here. With the help of tag name, I'm getting all the images in my page. Okay, with the help of a list of elements. Okay, it's using find by elements, and then I'm iterating with the help of for loop each element. I have used REST assured here, so you need to add one jar called REST assured. Okay, so I'm using that REST assured jar here. So you see REST assured dot given dot context type, I've given application suggestion, and then I've given and get. I'm just getting that element with the help of source. So this will give me the source of the image. Okay. Then I'm just checking what is the status. So it's giving me, if it is giving me 200, this means my image is available. The link is available. Okay. That is very simple. You can get it. Lot of website you will get this solution. Now I'm just what I'm doing extra here, along with the link. If it is giving 200, then only go inside that. I have not given any condition. I want to show you with what is the response coming for each link or image basically. And then I'm checking natural width. Okay, if the get attribute dot is equal to natural width is equal to 0, it means its width is 0. That means the image has not loaded. If a width of an image is 0, means that image has not loaded. So I'm just giving it get attribute natural width dot equal 0. It means if the image width is 0, it means the image has not loaded, so means the image is broken. So I'm just putting that attribute, source attribute, it is broken. If it is not equal to 0, then it is not broken. Okay, so this is a testng class. I have written one test annotation for one test. I'm just running with a right click testng. Okay, it will be open a website and it will give me all my details. So now you can see response is coming 200 for this image, which is from the image folder. 404 is coming for this image, means the image is broken. Okay, 404 means it's broken, it's not 200. Again, I'm checking with the natural width. So a natural width is coming 0, means it is broken. The second image, that is also broken. Then the fourth one is not broken because it is coming from the folder called image, so it is not broken. Now you can put some assertions. Now which one is broken and which one is not broken. Conditions, like you can put it here. Here again one more condition, if, and put everything inside this. If I'm getting 200, then you check another condition, which is the natural condition. Okay, and then I can put it this response code equal to . 200, then only you proceed and go into the next verification. Okay, and I'll just put this message outside so that we'll know what is the output is coming, and I'll run it again. Error. Okay, one extra S. Yes, control S. So control S is a shortcut to save any file. Okay, now if I see here, you see now only when 200 is coming, then only going inside and checking whether it is broken or not broken. First condition I have given 200. If it is coming 200, then it's checking the natural width. Now natural width is not 0, so it's broken and not broken. Okay, so now for the two broken, it's not printing, is broken. You can see it because first condition itself is failing, is 400, so it will not check for the natural width. For this, it is checking the natural width, so it's saying not broken. Checking 200 condition and this one also. Okay, so I'll put the code into the video. You can refer it, it's very easy. This is a very important, okay, to know whether the image has loaded the proper width and height or not. I hope you all enjoyed the video. Please do subscribe to my channel for new videos.